What's up, YouTube? In today's video, I'm going to show you how to elevate your Windows privileges by attacking unquoted Windows services. Let's get to it.
Login accepted.
All right, so let me minimize this VM. Okay, so whenever Windows starts a service, it uses the create process function. Now, if we scroll down, we can see that it has parameters here. And one of those parameters would be the application name that it needs to execute. So if we read this, it says, if you're using a long file name that contains a space, use quoted strings to indicate where the file name ends and the argument begins. Otherwise, the file name is ambiguous. For example, consider the string C program files subdir program name. This string can be interpreted in a number of ways. The system tries to interpret the possibilities in the following order. So you can see if the image path value that we were looking at contains spaces and it's unquoted, Windows isn't quite exactly sure where the executable is. It will interpret that in many different ways. So what Windows, or rather this process or this function create process tries to do is it basically separates the spaces and tries to find programs specific to that path. So as you can see here, first it tries to see if there's a file named program.exe, and then it uses everything following as a argument to that program. If it doesn't find it, then it moves on to the next space, which is cprogramfiles/sub.exe. Everything that follows is an argument. It doesn't find anything there, so then it moves on to the next one, program.exe, argument name, and then finally the actual executable name that was intended, or actually that was not the intended one. Oh yes, it was the intended one. So finally to the intended program, program_name.exe. So this creates the opportunity for us as a hacker trying to elevate our privileges to exploit this scenario. So if we find a situation like this, all we have to do is place a file named program.exe or sub.exe or program.exe in any of these locations, and instead of running the actual executable, Windows will find our executable first and instead execute that. So we're going to exploit the order in which Windows tries to find the program executable. So hopefully that makes a little sense, and if not, just hold tight and we're going to walk through that and exploit that right now. All right, so let's get back to our VM. And so this is the current file system path to our service. So if we look at this, we have several options that we could potentially use. So in this situation, Windows is first going to try to find a file named program.exe. Then it's going to try to find a file named programfiles.exe. Then vuln.exe, vuln.exe in the vuln service folder, and oops, and then finally the actual binary. So if we are able to place an executable at any of these locations, we can then exploit this service to execute our malicious executable file with system privileges. Now, this last one you kind of want to be careful about because this is the actual service. Now, you could, you know, theoretically overwrite this service, and if that's what you need to do, you can do that. However, I would definitely make a backup of the service executable before replacing it. That way, once you've elevated your privileges, you can replace the service binary file. But if we are able to write an executable at any of these locations, we can exploit this service and elevate our privileges. So what we need to do is see if we have write permission in the C drive. Then we'll need to check and see if we have write permission in program files x86. Then we'll need to check and see if we have permissions in program files x86 vuln service, and then finally vuln service bin. If we have write permissions in any of these locations, then our attack will work. All right, so let's take a look at how exactly we're going to do that. All right, so let's open up our command prompt, and we can use the program icacls, and we can use this to check permissions on folders. And it just basically shows permissions for any NTFS file system. And you can see here what the various permissions mean. So F, full access, M, modify, RX, read and execute access, etc., etc. So if you're unsure if what the permissions are when you list a permissions for a folder, you can just run the program and you can see what all the permissions are right here. All right, so let's go ahead and start by running it for just the C drive. So first we're doing just a C drive to see if we can write a program.exe or a program files.exe. So looking at this, we can see that the system user has full access, built-in administrators has full access, and it says me, Bob, I have full access. So I did not think I had full access to the C drive, so I'm just going to test that real quick. Let's do this. Okay, no, I do not. That's a little odd. I wonder what that's about. All right, so now let's move on to check the program files x86 folder for file permissions. Oops, got to remove that trailing backslash. All right, so trusted installer, system, administrator. So users have read, execute permission, which that's not write permission. That's not going to allow us to place any binary files in that location. But you can see we also have these permissions here, but none of those allow us to write files. And again, if you're unsure what those are, you can check them right here. They're all listed here. And then the creator owner has these permissions, which include full. However, since we did not create this service, it was created by a different user. That means we are not the owner, and therefore we do not have permission. So we do not have permissions to write in this folder. So now let's go ahead and check the next directory. All All right, so let's see. Built-in users. So that's basically any user accounts has full control. And that full control means we can read, write, execute, etc. So this means that we can exploit this service. We can write binary files into the vuln service folder inside the program files x86 directory. So perfect. We've found one folder which we can create an attack vector. So let's go ahead and check the last one just to see if we have write permission there. And in reality, we should, since we have permission, full control over the vuln service folder. And since this directory is inside the vuln service directory, therefore we should have permission there as well. But I'm just going to go ahead and run it for you guys anyways. Yep, sure enough, built-in users, full control. So whoever created, installed this service, whether it was a person or a piece of software, they made a mistake in allowing the directory permissions to be weak. Built-in users should not have full control over these directories when the binary placed inside these directories is running with permission services, or rather with system permissions. So at this point, all we need to do is make a malicious executable that does whatever we want it to do. And in this instance, I'm going to create a malicious executable that adds a new administrative user. And once we have that executable, all we have to do is place it in one of these locations. So none of those will work, but we could use any three of these. Place our executable in one of these locations, and the next time the service starts, our malicious executable will run, and then we will be able to then access this new administrator account. So let's go ahead and make this malicious executable. So in this example, I'm going to code this in C#. So let me get out of this VM.